In this trial workshop, I'm going to walk you through how to create a maintenance application, which will let you not only read data from the database, but also write data back to it. The first step you need to do is log in with the credentials we provided you in your welcome email. After that, you're going to click Create Apps, and since we wanted to build a maintenance app, we'll click Maintainers and Create New Maintainer. We'll need to give the application a name, and once you've done so, you can come down here and click Create Application. The next thing we needed to do is to tell Empower what table this application should be built over. In our case, we're going to pick the order header file, and I'm just going to select all of the fields. So come up here and click Select All Fields, then press Done. I'll press Next, and the next step is to go and specify dimensions. So dimension fields tells Empower how the application is, or how the table is unique. So in our case, this table should be unique by order number. So I'll click order number, and then I'll specify this as an auto sequence. If and when I add a new record, the next available order number will automatically be assigned with this feature. So I'll press Finish Model and Proceed. This gives me a preview of what the application will look like if I build it, and that's exactly what we'll do by clicking Build App. So Empower now is doing all the heavy lifting, taking all of the specifications that we used in building the application and generating all of the necessary pieces and parts, deploying it to the server, and as you can see here, telling me that it's now ready to run. So all I need to do now is click Run App. And you can see I now have a view of my data, and I can do lots of cool things like paginate through the records, and I can sort through things. I can also have some filtering, and the filtering is cool because it has a forward filter feature built in. So if I typed a 7 in here, it's going to bring back some of the orders here that begin with 7. Or really anything you wanted to search on. But what really makes this feature really cool is notice that there's an actions button, and I can click this actions button and I can change something about this. So instead of changing this order status to an R, I could change it to an A or something like that and press accept, and that will then write the record back to the database. You can see that it was once R, is now A. And I could also delete records if I wanted to do that as well, or I could even add a record. So notice that before I do that, the last order number entered was 808998, and if I add a new record, notice that it assigned me 808999.